Today, I feel like making a Pusha T type beat. Let me just tweet it out. All right, cool. So I just tweeted So, Lavery, what's going on, man? Right, so let me open this up. So this is what I have so far. Let's see. I sampled this chick. I'll bring it to here. She had a dope voice, so check this out.
You don't know, yeah, you don't know. You don't know a thing at all. You don't know about You don't know.
Yo, major talented. I don't even know her name, but Mike Caren follows her, so she's important, right? So what I did pretty much is I recorded it into my reference track, and then I put it in my social media rips right here.
Whoa.
So I just needed that part, and then I dragged it into Serato's sample. And these are the chops that right after I chopped it, I bounced it to audio. So let me solo it. So after I got that, I started getting Pusha T vibe, so I started making the track, and this is a loop that I had from years ago. Let me find it. It's in here. These are a bunch of loops that I made for a bunch of producers back in the day. Serum Style being one of them. Where is it? I think it's this one. Yeah, so I was rocking with that. So I put that in. I put the Voxengo tube amp on it to distort it a little bit to turn it into like a Kanye type track. So a Kanye type drum pattern or whatever. And then, of course, I'm taking some of the highs out. So enough talking. Let's get to it. Starts to get annoying after a while, but I'm still trying to find the melody that I want to play on top. So this may be a dummy mission, I don't know. Is my virus on? Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna play around on the virus for a little bit.
Thank you.
Let's see if I can get that out. May have to. I'm not sure if you guys can hear my virus. Alright, so let's get recording. So I gotta start on that. I messed that up. Let's get another pass. Ooh, that sound perfect. Perfect timing. All right, let's see how we get. That actually might be the wrong key. What key is this in? So it looks like A flat major, right? Yeah, so you got an A flat right here. A flat all the way, then you got the F. So it's creating almost an F minor type of chord. And then you got, and then you have this one. You have the second in A flat, you have the C. Yeah, so I don't know why it sounds a little trippy. That's just might need a little tuning. Let's go up like three. Oops, wrong. All right, let's remove Melodyne because we don't need it. All right, cool. So. Let's tune this up three a little bit. See how that sounds. All right, so I'm gonna have to work on this section some more. Tell me this is not gonna work. I love this vocal sample, but it's out of tune. And I don't have auto-tune. Let's try to correct it with Melodyne again. So we have, let's stay on A, good. Oh, this. So it's out of tune just by a little bit. Let's try to figure out this tune because I love this vocal sample. The thing is it tuned down or is it tuned? So let's just focus on one little section. So G sharp, that's A flat, but it's very, I can't tell which way because she has vibrato, but I'm gonna say it's tuned up too much because I see it more here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tune it down. I'm gonna give it like a negative 10 to start. Because I still have Melodyne on it. There was a way to remove Melodyne from here, but I forgot where I did it at. Yeah, see? How do I get rid of that Melodyne again? It was a... How do I get rid of that Melodyne? I forgot. Hold on. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. All right, so where were we? Oh, looking up how to remove Melodyne from the file. I know there is a way. I forgot. Anyway, seeming like a dummy mission, so I'm going to just move this one over, and then I'm going to tune it down 10. That sounds pretty cool. So let's get this fade a lot better because we're getting clicks. And I want it to sound like a sample, so I'm gonna fade it out like that. So let's see. In order to get it to sound like a sample, we gotta add it choppy. Oh, look at what we have here. A little bit of delay. It's probably OBS. OBS. All right, cool. So. Do this, and then I'm gonna duplicate because I feel like reversing. See how it sounds. Nope, too much. maybe I could fill it in the empty spots. So here, looks like we gotta, let's chop it. Fill the empty spots. Boom to here. So let's get rid of this. Fill the empty spots only. All right, cool. So what I'm gonna do with this? That's happening too fast. Let's keep it to see what happens. So I just have to correct these notes. Let me control B again. And let's edit with Melodyne, man. So where are we at now? So we're at, bring that there, bring that there, bring that there. Right, let's see. So it is A major, A flat. I ain't gonna lie, it's kinda seeming like a dummy mission right now. Maybe if I take down these articulate these I really want to use these samples, man. I really want to use it, man. I may not can use that sample. Maybe I can just have it buried underneath. Really low, let's see, 9, 3, -9. Sirius, what's up, man? Thanks for joining. I really wanna use this sample, but it's not working. It's not working, it's not working. This is So where is this happening at? I'm sorry guys, it's gonna be annoying for a little minute, but I gotta find this key. F sharp. So F sharp is definitely not in the key of A flat major. That's a C. So how can I get it where that F sharp and that C can still, let's see if I go up. One, two, one, two, three, four. I know it's gonna be in the key. So what if I go up one? If I go up one semitone, it'll be okay. So now, all right, it's between C sharp and all right, that should be good. Let's see. Hopefully, it works. You get lucky aligning the sample with the chord track. This one, I'm not sure what the chords are because, like here on the Virus, I was just playing A flat minor, I think. A flat minor into like an A flat suspended second. Maybe this track is supposed to be in the key of F minor. Sirius, you might have just got me onto something. Give me a second. Let me try some F minor stuff real quick with this. So I pitched it up 12. I'm gonna leave this at 0. And then I'm gonna reset this. I'm gonna mute these. I hate when I can't figure out the samples because she has so much vibrato. Can I detect chords from this? Let's see. right, so it says A flat major 7 like I expected, A flat major 7 like I expected. So why is it not sounding good? It's an A flat major 7. It's not sounding good, man. Hope this sounds good. Yeah. Thank you, Sirius. I appreciate that, man. This track, I kind of wanted to go through like the old Kanye stuff when he had Sock Passe doing a bunch of stuff. So if it's negative 3, we gotta go negative 15. Filter this out some more. I had Portal on it, but I'm not feeling that no more, so I'm gonna remove it. I can take the tuner off. All right, let's not waste any more time. Also have to be negative 15 because I'm not liking how bright that is. To sound like a sample. right, so let's see what we can get. Let me get rid of all of this because since I'm still working on this loop. So next, I have to find the kick that's gonna match this. What am I looking for? Kicks. Let's go back a pack. I like that. Let's see how that fits. One shot. What kick was that? Why does it sound funny? I kind of want this to be dominant. I might not even need a kick because the rhythm of the percussion, but I'm not sure if that percussion gets annoying after a while. So I kind of, maybe I'll switch it up on a verse. Swinging a little bit. So in fact, I'm gonna bounce these and then I can edit this one again so I can do some rolls. Mm-hmm. I reversed it. Hold on. Why are we playing around? Nope. I'm forcing it. I think that sample is a dummy mission. Let's just make the beat. A T-type beat, I gotta use my Mike Dean presets. What am I doing? Like, come on, man. Appreciate it, Leafy. Thank you. At this point, this is where I'm kind of struggling to find some counter melodies for this thing. I mean, Pusha T's beats are not very complex, but, you know, whatever. Thank you.
something darker than that. Stop trying to turn hip hop beats into R&B, bro.
I can do, man, because this is crazy. Chops. Let's go in chops real quick. Oh, chops. Maybe I can find like a vocal or something. Let's go through. I don't know if I could put that in that beat, but that's fly. Perfect loop. What I can do is do this until I find the we share the honors from me. I might have to go that route. Let's see how it fits.
Yeah.
feeling that will get annoying, but I know they like to rap over annoying beats. Bro, come on, man. Gonna bounce that. Let's detect chords on that one. See what they talk. See what they're working with. Maybe can't get them. Yeah, can't detect chords. So I'm gonna just go based off of this one right here. Oops. Let's go up 7. Alright, so if we went up 7, I go to 5, it's almost in key. So it's in key, but let's put RC20 on that because, oops, RC20, there we go. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to filter that. Why, oh why, something every... So maybe I could do this. Maybe I could do that. Maybe I'll have too much going on, but we'll see. Shift it over a little bit. Why did all of a sudden turn dark? Ay, we shall rhythm. We'll be right back. just picture Pusha T rapping about all of Perico right here, like, because that's what he does, right? Mm, cool. Now, what do they normally do? Like, they will have, like, 4 bars or 8 bars of the same pattern, and then they switch out into something super musical. But... Oh, no. Take that snare away, bro. What are we doing? I need something better. I need something more Mike Dean-esque. Where can I go? Where can I go to get that? Where can I go to get that? Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Oh. Hold up. Go back. Let's see what Z got in here. Nothing. I know I had a tonal. Maybe I got it in my Brian Kidd tribute. Let's see. Shout out to Leafy for this one. I think this was Leafy and my boy Sirocco. I need this. Sample One Third Party. No, it's Studio One. But they have equivalents, like I think you use Bitwig, right? So you can use, like, I don't know what their equivalent sampler is in Bitwig, but it's, they all, every DAW has a sampler. I guess this one just looks cool because, you know, it's a lot, you know. Whatever. All right, so I need something more tonal. Oh, I wasn't even looking for that, but let's throw that in there. Let's see what we look like. Thank you. matches. The verse, so I'm gonna go verse. Let's get the sequence going now. So this is a verse. What I'm gonna do, what is that, what's this, 8-bar? Instrument, yep. All right, so we got the verse. Now the hook, they usually go out and break into like some large choir type of deal. So let's see what I have. Let's go back in chops. Let's go back in all chops. Some Scotch Storch. Did you bring that back? I just heard something crazy on that. That's a Rick Ross intro right there. Maybach music. That's it. They usually just break out into a random sample, so we're just gonna break out into a random sample. See if we can break it. Yeah. one, the And Went? This one? It didn't match back up. Yo, No Gas, like when they make their beats, they'll have like a tempo going on the original beat that they had, and then the sample will be a whole different tempo. Like it'll end like this. Yeah, like they'll do that. And I don't know how they get that to sync like that. But I have to find the key to that Kim K effect. You got the Perico? Maybach music. Let's get the key. Let's see what they got. Take away that. Let's detect chords because Sirius put me on. So we got a B. B major looks like a B flat minor. B major. A B flat minor. A flat minor 7. And a B flat major, which is this. And a C minor 7. Wow, this is a crazy key. But I'm going to say that's in C. C minor. Let's see what happens with that. Take them African boys. Thank you. Let's chop. Let's get some of this right, right. Not cooperating, huh? Real quick, guys. It's taking me so long to do this beat today, but you know what? As long as I'm being productive, right? What are you doing? This is up 5, right? So I'm gonna go -3. I'm messing up. So this is going to be intro. All right, cool. How long I've been streaming? Wow, 1 hour and 14 minutes, and I don't have a complete beat yet? Virus sound, or maybe I do. All right, now we got to work on the hook. Then once I get the hook, I'll be done. So of course I want to carry that over. Give me the drugs. Give me the drugs. I want all the drugs. You already know what it is, something new in the city, we don't play, hey. So the chorus is gonna be 8. All right. like subtle, you know. Doing time out edit volume right. Oh, first of all, oh, I saved it already. All right, perfect. Let's just save it again. All right, first of all, what is it, global automation? Yeah, operator. Yo, you just find a preset, hope it work out. Hey. If I can break into the... Yeah, hold up. It's going to be a short break. Let's see if we can get it to do what I need it to do. All right, so we're going to drag that back here. It's going to be a short break because he's going to be rapping so hard. What in the world just happened? Oh, I cut it off too much. Okay, I see what I did. I wanted to do what happened in the intro with the dun 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 with the. All right, let's see. I hope someone can catch that rhythm, 'cause So how many bars is that? One, two, three, four, five, six. It's a six bar break. So I'm gonna name this break, right? And then I think I'm gonna come back in with the verses. Oh man, hopefully this works. This beat is a lot more trash than I expected it to be. Thought I had some dope. But you win some, you lose some, right? Yeah, I think that's all I'm gonna do. This is a little bit of a struggle. Not all beats are gonna be made in, 30 minutes to an hour, but I really wanted to complete this. I really did. It didn't come out how I expected it, but it's pretty, it's decent. It's decent. It's worth a post. Thank you. tonal situation real quick on that. Oh, is it loud? Yo, why do I have duplicates? Yo, what the fuck is this? I hope that's not why it's loud. That shouldn't be. I don't know if I would call this a struggle beat, because it definitely has potential, in my opinion. It's just that finding someone who can rap on this, it's gonna be a little tough. But I think I can get it out. Not the Pusha T per se, but it's a Pusha T type of track. These are. See, I have too much bass. Too much bass, not enough highs. So you know what I do to fix that? Let's tilt. Let's tilt. Should I use a good hertz tilt? Nah, I'll use Fab Filter, because you know, when you spend mad money on it, you gotta use it, right? Tilt. All right, so let's tilt it. Can I get a more? Let it rock right like that. Yo, why am I still clipping? It makes no sense. Let's see, drums as it's supposed to be. Drums. Yep, music. Oh, is it this one? Let's go music. All right, music. Spatial. Drum auto. No, this one has to go to, send that to the mix bus, right? Spatial goes to B. These go to global auto. We want to send that to the mix. No. Yeah, that has to go to global automation, because there's drum auto motion, mix bus. That goes to the mix bus. Yeah, I'm not sure why I'm clipping though. Oh. Duh. Ah! just bounce this, and then I'll play it. I'm not even sure if I'll upload this, to be honest. Let's see, projects, catalog. Stream beats. Push a struggle. What's the tempo? 91 BPM. Oh man. All right, guys. I think I'm done. I'm gonna take like a little hour break, and then I may stream again with a different beat. I didn't really get to use the original sample that I had originally when I started the video, because it just wasn't working. So, you know, things happen. Once it's done exporting. All right, decent waveform, not too crazy. So, all right, guys, thanks for tuning in to the live. Soul Avery, Sirius, Leafy, thank you guys for tuning in. Let me know if y'all want some, if y'all have some requests, man, I'm willing to do requests too. All right, so peace.